What's going on, everybody? So welcome to the WRL YouTube page. This season for Busch, I'm gonna have videos showcasing each track, my tips and tricks personally going into each race every week. I'm gonna try to have it up as we finish the NASCAR week on Wednesday night, so I'll have it up hopefully by Thursday for the next week for everyone to kind of get a chance to watch, learn some tips and tricks that I have for you going into each track. With this being said, Jade Burr, owner of Phantom Motorsports, president of the WRL, this is Daytona. Well, like I said, a few tips and tricks that I've learned here through the years of running. Obviously, the Busch cars are a lot different than the Cup cars. I personally, here, I run a party about a 2 or 3. I like it being a little bit more loose. It helps me hold the bottom a little bit more, because the fastest line around here is always going to be the bottom. Daytona's one of those tracks where it's kind of hard to really...
Okay, get back in there. Let's go.
...to really watch how you run. To really watch somebody by themselves and their line they run. So, the issue with Daytona... or not the issue, rather, more the there's more the thing with Daytona is that obviously this bottom line is going to be where all the dirty block the actions are. And yes, that's most how the Daytona races run here on the P5 game. Not a lot of people like the high line. It doesn't really work all that well for everybody. There's a lot of people aren't patient enough to stay with it. But if you get 2, 3, 4 good cars on the high line, you're gonna rock the game. You're gonna run a great. You can make the outside lane work here. You need to have people you trust and people that are going to stick with you regardless. If you are running by yourself, the best line high up in the straightaways and low down in the corners helps you not scrub off so much speed. It really allows you to get going. There's really no breaking points for Daytona. Maybe in the draft you might get 200 if you're towards the back of the pack. You're so slow by yourself, it's not even funny. I might get anywhere close to 46.6. So, pretty much Daytona in a nutshell. One thing you are going to have to really think about is how low you are running, because when you get so low, you're going to pop that apron and slide you real high. And most of the time, people behind you are going to lose momentum. They're going to come in as low, so you can't turn down like just like that. Big tips, some other rules. Like Daytona, obviously the yellow line, you can't go below it, especially on the back stretch, because you know you want to back up. If you do go down there, try to let off and get back in the draft behind everybody. Big thing is, I like to stay maybe a quarter of a car length off the yellow line. So, that's sure. That's kind of all I really got for Daytona here. So I'm going to kind of show you what I would do for tire preference. Obviously, the higher you go, the less wear you're going to have here, which is completely opposite of other tracks. Normally, the higher you go, the more wear you're going to have. But Daytona seems to be that opposite. Everybody, or any other track, I mean, rather. So, I get down to pit road speed here.
Watch your speed, please.
A little lower. So, normally, see how these are 50s. I normally put them up to about 45. It'll take about two green flag stops. Normally, I'll go up to like 35 here. And normally, catch a yellow. So I'm not gonna get it. Nope, too short. But that's pretty much it for Daytona. These pressures will help you hold the bottom along with the three. Really just depends on how you feel going into this race. This track's very, very easy.
You're clear on pit road.
But we are going to use the exit or the access road the whole way around the track. Yeah, I was going to see if I get a little bit closer. Hard to do if you can't lead in safety. You know, that's just not enough. If you're running full throttle, the top four cars are running full throttle all the time. You're not, there's no way safety will run out top four. That's the thing about Daytona, or and Talladega for that matter, either you. Sometimes you don't want to be the leader. One of the old tricks is you find your friends and you stick with them. You can't win this race with a person. Stage points are nice. This extra bonus point in the playoffs is definitely going to be nice, but sometimes it's not worth the risk. Damage the car, because once you damage the car's gone. It's never going to drive right again.
Excellent lap. Good job.
Of course, the car's never going to run straight again, no matter if you have zero damages or 0 seconds of damage. It's always going to be the same, and that's going to be what it is. Normally, run about 45 on the lefts and 50 on the rights. And we're finishing that, so we get a little fuel left, but it's gonna matter here. Yeah, that's pretty much Daytona in the Busch cars. Yeah, that's about all I got. So we're gonna finish this out here so we can get.
Excellent lap, good job. Six.
So, I guess that is definitely possible. Get a decent lap if you want to do. If you're running by, if you end up running by yourself, do what I say or do what I'm doing. Kind of just low and high. While you keep as much speed as possible coming off the turn, we'll be going straight as possible down this back turn. The cars do have to pull to the left and the right a little bit. Yeah, that's pretty much all I got here for this. Best of luck to everybody in the race in a few less than 24 hours from now. It's going to be a good race, I think. I'm really excited to see all the new guys come in and out, try to cement their legacy in the WRL. I'm all about storylines, and yeah. So, this is about it, Ben. About it for me for the title. We'll finish this lap, see if we can get in here, and kind of get from there. Sure to train the YouTube channel if you're not going to be racing tonight. Best of luck.